Now, Hectic was so the Dutch club that a few years ago turned into Access for All, and Access for All is now more or less a commercial company. And it feels like the hackers from the old days, the most of them became businessmen. But have you?
I'm not. I'm not a good businessman for selling myself. And the club has, in the environment of it, there are some businesses grown from people from club. But the club itself has his ideas for the purposes of the society. And there must be a division. It is impossible to make private all state things. Consumer rights, for example, you can't make private.
You cannot make that a case for everybody to fight. Some organization has to do that.
And in some manner, the Chaos Computer Club is like a information producer and consumer
advocacy group. You go for the consumer rights. Take, for instance, the internet. In Germany, how many people are using the internet?
I didn't know. It's a growing society.
It's a growing society. But have you taken a position, say, against the Bundespost?
They disappeared. There is not no private company. They tries to market globally one letter of the ASCII, the T, and try to make a trademark of it for Germany. There are other big players. The Bundespost, or the Telekom, is also cooperative. We had the possibility to visit the inner secrets of security of it, and
so you have become accepted by society instead of the early 80s revolutionaries. You are now more you become
influence pressure group in a manner we commonly discuss. Andy has asked me at the CBIT, I would be writing in the 80s. There was sometimes a decision to make either paragraph 129 or to be an eingetragener Verein.
You mean a club. An official club, yes.
An official club. And the other thing was a kriminelle Vereinigung. Was heißt das?
Yeah. Whether you were criminal conspiracy.
Yeah. And we did not the criminal conspiracy. And this decision was the base of the further things. But our own...
Yeah, but still, some of the members of the people around the Chaos Computer Club got into big trouble. And you told me in 1985... A guy who had been selling computer tapes to Russia got into... Tell me about it. What happened?
He got in so many conflicts, also personal conflicts and conflicts with society, also without jail, that he in the end burned himself. He named himself Hackbart after the book Illuminatus of Robert Anton Wilson. And it was for us very hard to see this event. For us, it was a first dead hacker in Germany.
So what happened is that the guy made some illegal actions trying to sell computer tapes to Russia, got into personal problems, and then in the end burned himself in the woods near Hanover. So that was quite a tragedy. Have there been, as we see that as a negative point, were there very positive dates, events for the Chaos Computer Club?
Very lustig, amazing thing was in the beginning of Bildschirmtext. We find out a possibility to exchange the content of an email on the computer of the receiver. Via Bildschirmtext. And this time the Bundespost was always saying, our things are good.
this is impossible, and
yes, and then we found it out and we communicated it to the public people who make data security, also Datenschutzbeauftragte. And we wrote in it, liebe Datenschützer, wir werden Sie mit diesem Schreiben fernbeleidigen und bitten schon jetzt um Verzeihung. Außerdem 1000 Stück Datenschutzberichte, nein, ein Stück Datenschutzberichte. That means, dear people, we would to say something very bad about you, and please
forgive us.
Forgive us. And then ship one piece of your publication. And then they phoned us and said, there is nothing in it. We must to forgive you. And okay, how you want to change this in my email? And then we copied some background pages with three defined characters on it. And after the one pieces, there were not three spaces, but three zeros. That means we want 1,000 pieces of it. Mm-hmm. And the first line was not dear Datenschützer, that means people who make data secure, but Dateischeißer. That means file shitter. And this was only an exchange of three or four letters in it. And then they know.
They understand what it was.
The forgiving was. And our big advantage there, a lot of important public people understand our mission. This was Copernican switch point or so, uh-huh, in our existence.
A turning point in the history. Lately, for the past few years, you've had annual big conferences on data security and social impact of computers, because those two things remain the main thing. On one hand, data security, trying to find out how you can get into Microsoft software or other software. On the other hand, the social implications of computers on society. And how big are these conferences?
It's family-like, we say, maybe 400 until 600 people, and a lot of them is knowing them, and it is divided in several sub-conferences, and in the last year we published some 100 kilobytes of Congress papers and results of it on the net.
So that's the thing. Now, apart from the Chaos Computer Club, let's talk with Wau Holland on the things that that concern us about the future of computers. And yesterday we had a discussion where we wrote it down about new rights in cyberspace, which was a very funny. So we came to a list of click rights, which is the right of people to click and see an information. Clip rights is to take information. And then we said lick rights. which is the right of people to use information for some purpose, like to embed it in their own text.
I say for private purposes.
For private purposes.
Not for sale purposes, but for private purposes.
Click rights, clip rights, lick rights. Another one is link rights. How do we... this is a current trend, of course, on the internet, that people say, on my heading on the page, I embed a frame, and in that frame I show, say, the news from the New York Times or the stock market figures. So it looks as if it's my publication, but in fact...
Oh, okay. I want to differentiate between link rights, that only setting of a pointer, and to embed rights. That's the point of. Take a frame and put it in. Mm-hmm. And the next version of it is robot rights. That means, I know it from Germany, there was a private company who used the public services of, oh God, was heißt Fahrplan? Timetable, yeah.
Yeah.
Of a timetable, the robot asked the other one to the timetable and put it in his own page as his own result.
So, Americans would probably call it agent rights.
Yeah, agent rights, okay.
Yeah.